children. Good morning children. Today we will come back to math class. Yesterday we did exercise 3.2, third completed. Now we go for fourth sum. In this fourth sum, which of the following pairs of linear equations are consistent, inconsistent? If inconsistent, obtain the solution graphically. So first you want to check, they will give two equations. First you want to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. So for that we are taking the first equation and we are going to verify. First equation, what is that? X plus y equal to 5, 2x plus 2y equal to 10. So here coefficients 1, now a1 equal to 1, b1 equal to 1, c1 equal to 5. Now a2 equal to 2, b2 equal to 2, c2 equal to 10. Here also equal to 10, here also equal to 5. So we can take c1 as 5 and c2 as 10. Now condition, we go check for the condition. A1 by A2, 1 by 2. A1 by A2, A1 1, A2 is 2. Now B1 by B2, B1, B1 means 1, B2 means 2. So A1 by A2 also 1 by 2 and B1 by B2 also 1 by 2. B1 by B2 also B1 by B2 1 by 2. Now we go for C1 by C2. C1 is 5 by C2 also 10. That equal to, if you cancel with 5 1s, 1 by 2. So what we observe here, A1 by A2 also 1 by 2, B1 by C2 also 1 by 2 and C1 by C2 also 1 by 2. All are equal. Therefore, what we can write the results? A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. So this 3 are equal means what is the nature? It is a consistent or coincident lines. It is consistent and dependent, and also infinite many solutions. So if it is infinite many solutions are consistent, then we go for graphical method. We want to check whether with the help of a graph. We will go for with the help of graph. Now there are two equations are there. So these two equations individually we want to find two or three solutions. First equation is x plus y equal to 5. First equation, x plus y equal to 5. First equation is x plus y equal to 5. If we take the solutions from this, from I am taking y equal to 5 minus x. If you check means here x plus y equal to 5. From this x and that side, plus x and that means minus x, y equal to 5 minus x. For this also we are going to find out two or three solutions. Now what is the variable here? X. So x equal to 0. Now what will happen? Y equal to 5 minus 0, that equal to 5. Now x comma y equal to, x value is 0, y value is 5. Now x equal to 1. Now what will happen? y equal to 5 minus 1, that equal to 4. Now x comma y equal to 1 comma 4. Now x equal to 2. Now y equal to 5 minus x, that equal to 5 minus 2, that equal to 3. Now x comma y equal to 2, 3. These are the solutions for the first equation. Now go for second equation. 2x plus 2y equal to 10. 2x plus 2y equal to 10. Now everywhere common you want to be observed. Here also 2 is there, here also 2 is there, here also 2 is there. We can take 2 as a common. Now what will happen? X plus y equal to 2 ones, 2 fives. Now this is equation number 2. What we get the equation here? Here also same equation we will get. Now same solution also we will get same solutions. Now y equal to 5 minus x. From this what we take the values here also? We can take x equal to 0. Now what will happen? Y equal to 5 minus 0, that equal to 5. Now x comma y equal to, x comma y equal to 0 comma 5. 0 comma 5. X equal to 1. X equal to 1. Now what will happen? Y equal to 5 minus x. That equal to 5 minus 1. That equal to 4. Now x comma y equal to, x comma y equal to 1 comma, x comma y equal to 1 comma 4. Now x equal to 2. Now y equal to 5 minus x, that equal to 5 minus 2, that equal to 3. Now x comma y equal to, x comma y equal to 2 comma 3. We can take the values. Now for this, these values we can draw in a tabular form. In the tabular form, if you go for table means, if you write the table here, x, y, x plus y equal to 5, here 0 comma 5, then 1 comma 4, 1 comma 4, 2 comma 3, these are the first values. And the second equation also same values. What are the second equation? X plus here 2x plus 2y plus 10 equal to 10 given. Divide by 2 means what will get? Same equation will get. So x plus y equal to 5. For this also we want to take the values like this. This is x and y. This is x and y. First value is 0 comma 5. Second value 1 comma 4. And third value 2, 3. These values I am going to plot in the graph paper. So horizontal line and vertical line, there are two lines I am taking. The intersecting point of x axis and y axis is called as origin. X axis and y axis is called as origin. Now I am taking, going to take the graph of this, these values I am going to take the, here if you observe this, all the values are 1, 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 4, 3. Here also all positive values only. For that I am going to take Q1. I am going to take for this Q1. So here X, O, X dash, Y dash and Y. Here these values can be take the equally, we can divide the x-axis. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like this I am taking. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, etc. And similarly, here also I want to divide equally 1 centimeter. If you have to like this means, you can do like this. Now here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, etc. Now I am going to take the first line, 0, 5. 0, 5 means x axis 0, y axis 5. This is 0, 5. Then x axis 1, y axis 4. X axis 1, y axis 4. 1, 4, then 2, 3, x axis 2, y axis 3, y axis 3. This is the one line. This line is nothing but what this line x plus y, x plus y equal to 5. Now, next second equation is also same values 0, 5, 0, 5, 0, 5, 1, 4, 1, 4, 2, 3. So second equation also same. So already one line I drawn already. This is second line. All the coincidence lines. These are the coincidence lines. This equation is x plus y equal to 5. So this is the, suppose they will ask, find the area of this triangle. They will ask means what we can do. Find the area of the triangle. Sometimes they will ask in the board exam, find the area of triangle. They will ask means this is base and this is height. So how many units of base? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So base equal to 5 units, and height also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. Height also 5 units. Now they are asking area of triangle. Area of triangle equal to half into base into height. Half into base into height. That equal to half into 5 into 5, that equal to 25 by 2 square units. That equal to 12.5 square units. This area of triangle is square. There is no need, it will be asked in the sum, but in the board exam they will ask like this. Now, for this scale, how will you take the scale? Scale is x axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Then y-axis also, y-axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. This is the scale. Now, this is the nature of the coincidence lines. So, when it is possible, what is the condition for coincidence lines? A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. If the three are equal, then the graph will come one line, on this line another graph will also will come. Actually area they didn't ask in the book, but I am only finding the area because sometimes in board exam they will ask like this also. Now we go for fourth row one second question now we are going to discuss. So in the fourth question, what they ask in the question, whether the given pair of equations consistent or inconsistent. Consistent, first question what we need, it is consistent and dependent, and also it has infinite many solutions. Now we go for fourth row one second question. What is the fourth question second row one given? X minus y equal to 8. X minus y equal to 8. 3x minus 3y equal to 16 they given. Now here a1 equal to 1. Now b1 equal to minus 1. c1 equal to 8. Now come to the second equation. A2 equal to 3, B2 equal to minus 3, C2 equal to 16. Now A1 by A2, A1 means 1 by 3. Now B1 by B1 minus 1 by minus 3, minus minus cancel, 1 by 3. A1 by A2 also 1 by 3, B1 by B2 also 1 by 3. These two are equal, then we go for third condition, C1 by C2. C1 what is that? 8 by 16. 8 ones, 8 twos. So what is the nature here? A1 by A2 1 by 3, B1 by B2 1 by 3, then C1 by C2 1 by 2 came. Therefore, A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. So what is the nature of the lines? Here, no solution. There is no solution this type of question, this type of equations, and it is inconsistent. Inconsistent. So inconsistent means no need to find the solution, because it is, there is no solution. What is the nature of the line? How the graph will come? Like this, parallel lines only will come. Parallel lines only will come for this option. Now we go for third question. Fourth Roman, third question, if you observe, means here also we want to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. If you go for third question, means what is that? Here, fourth question, 2x minus 2y minus 2 equal to 0, 4x minus 4y, 4x minus 4x minus 2y minus 4 equal to 0. Now there are two equations are given. If you observe the two equations, means first equation 2x minus 2y, 2x minus, third question 2x minus 2x plus y minus 6 equal to 0, 4x minus 2y minus 4, 2x minus 4x minus 2y minus 4 equal to 0. If you observe that these two questions means, we go for, now we want to check whether condition A1 equal to 2, B1 equal to 1, here quotient of 1 is 1, C1 equal to minus 6. Now if you go for A2 equal to 4, B2 equal to minus 2, B2 equal to minus 2, and C2 equal to minus 4. Now if you want to check the values, means A1 by A2, A1 by 2x plus y equal to 2x plus y minus 6 equal to 0, 4x minus 2y minus 4 equal to 0. Yes. Now A1 by A2, 2 by 4, that equal to 1 by 2. Then B1 by B2, B1 by B2, 1 by minus 2, B1 by B2, B1 by B2 is 1 by minus 2. If you observe, is here only, not equal to here. Therefore, what we can write the results? A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. So, what is the nature of this line? It is consistent. It is consistent. How many solutions? Unique solution. Unique solution or one solution. How many solutions will come? One solution only will come for this type of questions. Now we go for finding solutions. Finding the solutions of this equation 1 and equation 2. Finding the solution of equation 1 and equation 2. Now y equal to, these two values on this side, 6 minus 2x. Y equal to 6 minus 2x. 6 minus 2x. So here y value is there, minus 6 going to the plus 6, 2x coming to the same, minus 6. Now x equal to 0. X equal to 0. Now y equal to 6 minus 2 into 0. 2 into x, that equal to 6 minus 2 into 0, that equal to 6 minus 0, that equal to 6. Now x comma y equal to 0 comma 6. 0 comma 6. Now x equal to 2. If you take x equal to 2 means what is the equation? 6 minus 2x that equal to 6 minus 2 into 2 that equal to 6 minus 4 that equal to 2. X also 2, y also 2. X comma y equal to 2 comma 2. Every x comma y equal to 2 comma 2. Now, go for second equation. What is the second equation? 4x minus 2y minus 4 equal to 0. Divide by 2 every term. Now what will happen? 2x minus y minus 2 equal to 0. Now this value y alone take that side. 2x minus 2 equal to y. That implies y equal to 2x minus 2. This is the equation. Now y equal to 2x minus 2. Now for this I am taking x equal to 0. X equal to 2. X equal to 2 means what will happen? Y equal to 2 into 2 minus 2. That equal to 4 minus 2. That equal to 2. Now x comma y equal to 2 comma 2. So look at here. Here also 2 comma 2 came. Here also 2 comma 2 came. So where we observe the common solutions for the both equations, that is the solution of the linear equations in two variables. Now another equation we want to take 3. Now x equal to 3. If we take x equal to 3 means what will happen? Y equal to 2x minus 2. That equal to 2 into 3 minus 2. That equal to 2 3 is 6 minus 2, 4. Now x comma y equal to 3 comma 4. 3 comma 4. If you plot the points on the, you can prepare one table for this. If you prepare the table for the both equations, means what will happen? First values. So first values x and y. 0 comma 6. 0 comma 6. 2 comma 2. 6 comma 6. 2 comma 2. Now go for second table. If you go for second table, means what will happen? This is for this is y equal to, this is y equal to 6 minus 2x. And then second equation. If you go for second equation means x comma y, then what are the values? 2 comma 2, then 3 comma 4. 2 comma 2, then 3 comma 4. These values can be plot in the graph paper. Means what will happen? I am going to observe. Now these values should be flat on the graph paper. If you observe the graph, means so the intersecting lines will come. Already we discussed the condition. The intersecting lines will come. So this is all our positive values. For that we go for only x axis. No need to go for fourth quadrants. Here q1 is enough. Then this is y dash, this is x dash, and this is x. If you take like this, means this is x axis and y axis, and we can divide each partition, each centimeter, according to our convenience. We can take the graph. Now here maximum value 6. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like this we can take. And if you come to the x axis, means x axis also, we want to divide each 1 centimeter, then 1, 2, like this we can divide, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like this we can take. First value, 0, 6, 0, 6, it is only 0, 6, x axis 0, y axis 6, 0, 6, and 2, 2, x axis 2 and y axis 2, this is 2, 2, if you join the line means like this, one line will come. This line represents y equal to 6 minus 2x, 6 minus 2x, and then go for second equation. Second equation solutions means 2, 2, 2, 2, and 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4. If you like to like this means 3, 3. So where the two line graphs are intersecting, that means 2, 2. So x equal to 2 and y also 2 is the solution. So y equal to 2. X equal to 2 and y equal to 2. Scale. Scale x axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. Y axis 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. So this is the nature of the graph. Third one we completed. Fourth one you are going to verify. Thank you, children.